722. Welcome back to 13 Sunrise. This morning, Pat Sullivan from Sullivan Hardware and Garden is stopping by.
Yes, that's right. Today he talks all about outdoor painting for the fall.
Well, we finally have some fall-like weather. So I was going to do this segment a few weeks ago, but we are stuck in that 90-degree heat. But now it seems more like fall, getting a little bit of rain. We could still use more, of course. So fall is a great time to paint because low humidity, lower temperatures, and it's just a really great time. So right now would be a time if you're thinking about doing a little painting. But the problem with painting, whether you're doing it yourself or whether you're hiring somebody, is that we probably jump too quickly to get going because we want to see the finished color. And you know, there's a lot of prep work to do, and you know, just cleaning. You know, I mean, the house needs to be, this is just a house prep cleaner. There's all kinds out there, because look at this. Just this is, and I live on a pretty, you know, there's not a lot of traffic in the neighborhood, and just if I just do this, it's just what's in the air, and that is all something that will keep the paint from sticking properly. We had our house painted a few years ago, and it started peeling. You know, the other side of the house peeled. I thought, well, we're gonna have to replace the siding. So I had another contractor that I know and trust, and he came in. It's perfect because he did the prep. He scraped, you know, some of the tools of the trade, scrapers, wire brushes, cleaning it. Caulking is really important, a great time to do, to stop the air infiltration into your home to help with your fuel bills. And then the primer. You've got to have primer on spots, whether you prime the whole thing or if you're just priming the areas that have peeled in the past. Those are all things that have to be done properly. And then, of course, when you get the very best paint, because I'm not so sure if it was the prep or the bad paint from the last time, but we used a top quality paint and it has stuck, and it's been great. So some of the other things that you're gonna think about, especially if you're gonna have somebody paint it for you, is the color. Now this is where, no matter what brand you get, this is Benjamin Moore, start with these, because if you don't have a good handle on color, these are color combinations. So when you look at them, you can go, wow, some expert says these go together. So really important, because sometimes, you know, you go down the street and you see that house and go, ooh, they missed. You know, might be the garage door or something. It's like, it just didn't work out, because looking at those little chips in the store, you know, you don't get, you know, they're always darker than what you think they're gonna be. And so that's the other thing. You should have 10, 12, 15 of these little sample things that you've tried. And I recommend you put your sample on the back of the house, because you don't want neighbors coming over and throwing their opinion in. It's gotta be what you like, but keep trying different things until you find the right combo. So don't just go, yeah, this is fine. So take your time, do the prep, get the color you want, and then on the door you get your own little special color. Now don't go putting this everywhere. Just on the front door. You don't want to do everything with it, then you lose the specialness of it. All right, so great time to paint. It'll make the house look new again.
Yeah, it is amazing what paint can do. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Pat. And if you miss any of Pat's previous segments, you're in luck. He has his own streaming show on WTHR+, so you can catch up with all of Pat's home improvement tips. Get Pat anytime, right? You can download the free WTHR Plus app on Roku, Fire TV, and Apple TV.